Don't use Docker Compose in production for an app running on multiple servers. Instead, you should use an orchestration tool like Swarm, Nomad, or Kubernetes. But won't it take days or even weeks to convert a Docker Compose app to Kubernetes? Not really. In fact, I can show you how to do it in less than 10 minutes using a tool called Compose. Here is a Docker Compose file with two containers, one for Nginx over here and one for an app in Bun over here. Now I've got Docker running in the background, so if I go to the browser and navigate to localhost, we can see the app is running in all its glory of just text, which is fine because it illustrates Nginx working with Bun. Now, in order to convert our Docker Compose file to Kubernetes manifests, we need three things: kubectl, which is a command line tool for Kubernetes, Compose with a K, which is the tool that will actually convert our Docker Compose file into Kubernetes manifests. And last, we'll use a tool called kind, which lets us create a Kubernetes cluster locally on our machine. If you're on a Mac, all these things can be installed with brew. But if you're on Linux or Windows, then I'm sure you can figure it out. Anyway, once you've got those installed, we're ready to go. But before we do that, if you like Kubernetes and all things system design, then you're going to love our free newsletter, Hacking Scale. All the articles are really short, around 5 minutes, and focus on how big tech companies like GitHub, Dropbox, and LinkedIn were able to solve big scaling issues. So go and check it out. And we're back. Okay, let's go to our terminal, navigate to our project directory. Mine is called wishlist app, and we're going to run this command, which is going to use compose to convert our Docker Compose files into Kubernetes manifests and put them in a folder called K8S. Wow, that was quick. Let's take a look at these files in our project. Okay, we have a new K8S folder, and would you look at that? We have all these Kubernetes manifests ready to go. We've got deployment, a configuration map, and some services. But don't be freaked out by these Compose annotations. They're just a way for Compose to track the resources it's created. If you want, you can get rid of them, and everything should work just fine. But for now, I'm going to leave it. Let's go ahead and create resources from these files. As you may have figured out, I'm going to be using kind to create a local Kubernetes cluster. But if you're more familiar with Minikube or Kubernetes in Docker Desktop, then you can go ahead and use that instead. Let's go ahead and run this command, which is going to create a kind cluster using a configuration file that's going to expose the ports. If you're interested in exactly what this file contains, I'm going to put a link to it in the description. And after fast forwarding this video, we have our cluster, which is able to get public Docker images like Nginx, but it won't have access to our local Bun app. So let's go ahead and add that image to our cluster using this command. Nice. Now we can create Kubernetes resources from our manifest files using kubectl. I'm going to write this command and hit enter. And look at that. We've just created resources from all of our files without any issues. Let's take a look at them. If I run kubectl get all, wow, we have two pods over here. We have three services, we have some deployments, and we have some replica sets. But we've got two massive issues. First, one of our pods are just not running. We have the error of image pull back off. And the second issue is none of our ports are exposed, so there's no way we can access our app. Why does nothing ever work the first time? Okay, let's deal with these issues. I'm going to run this command. If you're wondering why I ran a Docker exec command to check a Kubernetes node, well, this is because kind uses Docker containers as nodes for Kubernetes. So using Docker exec lets us run commands inside our Kubernetes node to see all the images available to our kind cluster. And here we can see that Bun wishlist exists, but it's not being picked up because it has the tag of latest. And Kubernetes by default has a different pull policy for images tagged as latest. So let's go ahead and change that. In our deployment manifest for Bun, let's go ahead and add this new pull policy. This means Kubernetes will use the image on the node instead of pulling from the registry, which is what we want. Now let's go back to our terminal and apply the updated manifest file. And now if we check our resources, we can see that both pods are running. Nice. To fix the other issue, we have to change this service from a cluster IP to a node port and give it a port number to expose. But before we do that, if you enjoy managing resource clusters and observing them, checking logs and metrics, then you're going to need an observability platform. And if you want the best, I mean the best observability platform, then you need to check out BetterStack, because it has a ton of features like log management, metrics, status pages, incident management, and much, much more. Oh, and did I mention it costs nothing to get started? Yep, that's right, $0. So what's your excuse? Go ahead and check out BetterStack right now. Okay, we're back. Let's go ahead and update the Nginx service manifest file. Here, we're going to add a new type of node port. And underneath target port, we're going to add a node port of 30,000. This matches the port number in our client configuration file. Now let's apply this manifest. And if we look at our resources, we can see we have a port exposed to us. And that should be it. Let's navigate to port 30,000 in our browser. And bang, we can see our app is running in Kubernetes. That is awesome. Is that it? What about the ingress resource? And he's only running it locally. I want to see it in production. If you have those questions, then you should definitely subscribe.